Okay, this is how we're gonna do it. That's just not a good view. I thought my laptop could take video, but can't. So we'll just use the iPhone for now. The lighting's not good, but we're gonna do it. Okay, tonight we are making tacos. So I've got the meat and the beautiful meat grinder and just grinding up the meat. We love tacos here at this household. If we weren't moving, I'd be able to show you a sign that's nothing haunts us like the tacos we don't eat. Oh my God, I just found a perfect place to put you. Give me 1 second. Well, you can see me good. Can't see your skin cooking. I can talk to you about it though. So, there really is never a method to what I do. Just cook. Make sure it tastes good and have fun. Definitely have fun. Don't know if you can hear the music in the background, but always have music so that you can dance when you're not cooking. Am I getting nervous?
No.
Make me nervous. While I'm doing this, I can multitask and show you my Polaroid fridge. I love Polaroids. And I got a mini Polaroid camera for my birthday last year. Also multitasking, here's the seasoning we use. If you can see, it's Taco Bell, of course. Everything's gotta be Taco Bell, man. That's one thing you'll learn. This girl loves Taco Bell. And we can take a break for a second just to show you the Taco Bell sauces. Give me a second. So, we have all my milds. Mild. I bought medium because I finally found it. Some more up there. Yeah. Never have enough Taco Bell sauce. I'm gonna put you over here so you can see what I'm doing. I feel like just my face isn't great. Okay. Do you guys like hard or soft shells for your tacos? Comment below. That's hilarious. Okay. Getting it up. It's just cooking a Jake. Cooking on Jake. Cooking Jake cooking. We don't know what to title this. We'll see. Right, it's pretty mushed up. So now we're just gonna let it brown. We'll just get off all the meat off the meat smasher. Meat grinder? It's not a meat grinder, but whatever. Meat smasher. I like that. Sounds intense. Okay. We'll keep this out on our little spoon rests just in case we need it. But it's pretty mushed up. So now we just gotta let it brown. Always gotta have a spoon rest. So many spoon rests. Put the lid on it. Let it do its thing. Then we'll look at here and see how many cups of water we need to prep that. 3/4 for 1 pound. We are making 2 pounds. So math. One fourth. I should probably look that up maybe. I don't know. We just go with it? I'm gonna go with it. We'll just go with it. Then the other ingredients we need are some lettuce. Those can be thrown away. Cheese, of course. That's the half of cheese. No! Alright, our cream. We chopped up our lettuce and cheese. Old El Paso. Old El Paso. 3 pepper blend and their Mexican blend. Mm. Okay, lettuce. Make sure you wash it first. Always wash your Produce. Shake. Set that there. Grab your knife. Cut like you usually do. And that, but you want to see that? You can't see that. Hopefully you stay. Just cutting, cut the lettuce, making it shredded. We're gonna have tacos for the week, so we're gonna cut it all up. Some of you might think, what, you can eat tacos for a whole week? Gosh dang right we can. Eat tacos for the rest of this life that I live. Cutting it up just a little bit more, sometimes it gets a little big. So go through one more time the opposite way. We washed it, so we're good. And we'll put it in a bowl. Lettuce is chopped. I wonder, can you hear me over the music? That's what I'm wondering. This is a test run. Test run. Take one. Okay. Cleaned up that. A towel just to wipe off the cutting board. You don't want to push that back in. Icky, icky. Throw that out in the garbage. All right. Check on the meat. And now you can't see it over my bowl of lettuce. It's looking good. Getting browned.
I don't want to get too attached, but I feel like I already am.
Definitely going to need to drain that. Holy moly.
My mindset.
Right. Turn it up a little to get it cooking quicker.
Right.
Definitely aren't ready for these yet, but let's get them out and ready. This is how many soft shells we're buying. No joke. Two of these. Probably have it on me while I do that. Okay. Alright. We have to mix Jordan's hot sauce. They are out of Taco Bell hot sauce. Fresh. So, we will grab some chipotle pepper. Your hot stuff. Hot sauce. I got him this for Valentine's Day. We will mix it up. We'll use this. I'll check if I see. God, I got him ready to turn you. Okay. Just some mild. And then you pour in the hot. Again, there's no method to it. You just do it. There's no measuring in this kitchen. Don't ask me why. Mix. I don't taste test this because I don't like spicy. So just go off smell. Doesn't smell hot enough yet, so we'll add a little more. That might have been too much. Can always add more. More than that anyways. What am I thinking? Okay. Now we'll add just a little bit more hot. And then call it good. Just a little, Mix. Yep, that's done. Turning you. You can't even see anyways, but. I turn you anyways. Meat's looking good, nice and brown. Very, very watery. Oh, there's some good pieces, so we'll let it go a couple minutes more. And then. We're gonna drain it. We're gonna try whatever the. What did we say? Meat smasher? Some of these pieces got clumped. So just take it, flip it a wrist. quicker to roast. Pepper blend can get spicy, just a little spicy. You didn't see that. Get a spoon for the sour cream. Pro tip, if you don't want that puddle of liquid that's usually there, like it is right now, if you flatten your sour cream, oh god, I just spilled. If you make sure it's flat when you put the cover on it and let it sit in the fridge, it's less liquidy because it doesn't have as much of a area to build up. And then you don't spill on your counter like that. Oh, and we didn't clean up. Good, we just spread. Just spread the mess. Then you gotta mix it up and it's just messy. So when you're done with it, it's so hard to remember, put it flat, like flatten it. I'll show you at the end. Right now, I'm not going to. All right, and we got the sour cream. I need this still. Definitely don't need this. Put in this bike. Okay, I'm gonna leave this out in case I feel like using that one. Put the knife in the seat. Turning you back so you can watch me do the meat one more time. Hopefully, it's done. Looks. Don't see any big pieces. So, to drain, just turn your sink water on super, super hot. Don't know if this is recommended. Super, super hot. Let it sit, get hot. And then you drain the meat into the sink. Don't know if you're supposed to do that. I won't tell. Oh, that one. That's for skin. All right, we're going to go drain the meat. It's a hard process. Continue to run down it after you're done for just a little. Now we're going to dump this in. Oh, turn your heat down. I'm not doing good at explaining the steps. But turn the heat down once you bring it back. Dump your seasonings on it. You can shut the water off probably. Ooh, hear that sizzle. That sizzle. Alright. Taco seasonings in. Take your water, dump the water, and mix. And mix. Get all the burger meat and the taco meat coated in the taco sauce. There you go. And then, once it looks pretty evenly coated, we are going to put the lid on and let it simmer with it so that it really cooks into the meat and seasons it. Don't ask me if it actually seasons it more. I don't know. But we do it just to do it. Alright. Evenly seasoned. We won't need that boy anymore. This had raw meat on it, so put it in the sink. Turn your heat to a simmer. And lid it up. Rinse off your meat for me, meat snatcher. Throw away your garbage. And start getting plating ready. So, two plates. Tortilla. 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 Tortilla.
Clip these back up.
And while we wait, I'm going to show you my kitchen. So, nothing spectacular, but it gets the job done. There is a theme in here. I don't know if you see it, but it is teal and gray. I love it. All right. We are waiting for that. And this is why your music plays, so while you wait, you can have a jam session. There's a lid on there, so don't worry about my hair getting in it. Do you want to see my fridge? Inside, nothing special. That's a pasta salad. We got top of the tater, obviously. Butter, potatoes, ouch! Beer, duh. Wine, duh. Some more wine. More wine. Bailey's, mayo, purified water. This is the vegetable drawer. There is celery there. The meat drawer's got some ham and bacon. And then, whoa! Condiments. My favorite. Freezer's nothing in pressing. Just my meats that I package up for the week. Bread, if you want to freeze your bread so that it lasts longer. Ice, more bread, hash browns, veggies in the corner, and that's it. And that's it. All right, we've wasted enough time. Let's go heat up the tortillas. Heat up the tortillas. 15 seconds. 15 seconds for two, or 15 seconds for one. 15 seconds. Simmer. Oh, crap. Always stop the microwave before one. Shoot. Man, we didn't get it today. Alright. I can get mine ready. I use some sour cream. Here's the pro tip on how to make a taco. Put your sour cream. Can you see? Come down. There you go. Sour cream first. That way you can get as much as you want, which is a lot for me. Then come your tacos. Do we need a draining spoon? We do. Alright, drain the meat just a little so it's not super runny. Drop it on. Drop it like it's out. Alright, that was taco sauce on my plate. Now we add cheese. So, step one, sour cream. Meat, cheese. Talks. Three nights at the motel, the street lights in the city of Paul. Okay, and then hot sauce. Mild. Taco sauce. Whatever. And then wrap. Do you guys want to see me wrap it? Mm-hmm. Here we are. Can you see? I think so. Let me take this. Wrap your sides. Fold in. Keep them tucked. Hold carefully. You gotta be gentle with the shells, otherwise it'll break. And there you go. The perfect burrito. Round two. Sour cream. It might have been a pot of sour cream on the other. I don't know. Might be getting nervous being on camera. And then your meat. Step three, cheese. Lots of cheese. And then we got lettuce. taco sauce. All right. And then wrap it. Wrap it up. Wrap it up. All right. Gotta put the taco sour cream out on your own first bite. You just can't go wrong with tacos. Okay, I need to wash my hands. Alright, Jordan, not simpler. It's just me. I didn't mean just me, I meant like no sour cream. And then cheese. Little lettuce. Oh, lots of cheese. A little bit of lettuce. And his personally made hot sauce. And wrap. Again, gentle. Tucking, tucking, folding, tucking, wrapping, tucking. Burrito one. More meat. Lots of cheese. A little bit of lettuce. Might have been a lot. Little. And then the rest of the sauce. Because I don't need it, so we're not gonna leave it. Rinse this off so it don't harden. Life hack. Life will be easier if you rinse your dishes right away. That's a Justine life hack. Okay, I can't find an end here that I can get nicely from the shelf. Got it. And then wrap. Tuck in the edges. Fold it. Don't puncture it. Don't put a hole in it. Wrap, wrap, wrap. And there we go. Two burritos. Done. For the sour cream trick real quick before we go eat. I don't know why I bring it up here. Oh, I almost just got sour cream. So you just flatten it. So make sure that the top layer is left. Oh, I'm not even showing you, sorry. Make sure it's flat like that. As flat as you can make it, and that'll help you to not have that liquid or cream when you open it next time. Thanks for joining Cooking with Dave. We'll see you next time when we cook dinner. Bye.